With this workflow, you never again have to worry about paying for an expensive professional photo. Simply upload a reference photo of yourself, run the workflow, and it'll generate, using OpenAI's Image 1 model, an exquisite photo that you can use for your professional profile pictures. All right, now before we get too far into this, I do want to say that this workflow probably isn't for everybody and it may not be for you. This may not be something that you need or care about, and particularly because I'll admit the results aren't that great. I actually decided to work on this one when a member of my school community came and had a new profile picture. I'm like, oh, hey, that's really cool. Like, nice job. You look great. And he's like, oh, no, it was entirely AI. I was able to use ChatGPT and make a photo. I'm like, oh, I wonder if I could build a workflow to do that. And so I built a workflow to be able to do it. And I want to say that it is not quite as good as ChatGPT. I can show you the results here at the end. So just be aware that this may not necessarily be for you. It may not necessarily make the level of quality of photo that you're looking for. But for somebody out there who can't necessarily afford a professional photographer, it probably gets it close enough and you could probably use what it generates. So let's go ahead and actually take a look at some of the photos that it makes. We'll come up here. So I ran it a couple times, you'll be able to see. So I gave it a reference photo of myself. Before we do that, let me show you the reference photo. So I have my reference photo. Here I am. I just took a picture of myself in front of my green screen with, it was just the other day. I wasn't even looking good, right? So there I am. And I, that's it. That's the photo we're using here. And we had it create some photos. So we got this one. I mean, I kind of see a little bit of me in it. It's not really me. Here's another one. Again, it's kind of got the cheek thing, but like the forehead maybe, but it's not, I don't think it's me. And then there's another one. So these are close. In fact, the eye color isn't even right in these, which is funny because the prompt tells it to use a light color. But so that's what the generator made. And I did use ChatGPT. I gave it 3 reference photos. And this is what it gave. It kind of looks like the other ones, but I'll admit this is probably the closest of the various headshots that I had. But, you know, it can work. I mean, I very well probably could get away with maybe that one. Might be able to pull off that one. And if you ran it a few times, you'd be able to get something that looks probably closer to you. So let's go ahead and actually talk about how it works so that you can start generating your own professional photography pictures, your own professional headshots, so you can use it on your professional profiles and all that. So not particularly complex. Some of my other workflows, you know, are big old monsters. This one's nice and straightforward. We're just using a click trigger. There's nothing special about it, just a click trigger. We are then using a Google Drive node to search a folder. In this case, we are searching in the first reference image folder. I tried to build this so that I could have multiple reference images, and I found out as I was building that with the OpenAI Image 1 or the GPT Image 1 model, you're only able to give it one reference image. So unfortunately, we could only work with one. I tried, it was gonna be more complex with multiple images. I just couldn't get it to work. There was no way, they're just not possible to be able to do 3. I even tried adding like a collage, and honestly, just one photo worked the best. So that's how we set it up. So just again, we're searching inside of the folder for a reference image, really just one. It's gonna go ahead and download that image. Okay, we're downloading it based on the ID. And then we get this over here. And we're gonna pass that to an HTTP request node. And our endpoint, I guess I should say our method is post, our URL is https://api.openai.com/v1/images/edits. We're using the edits endpoint. Now again, I did try the other endpoints, the variations endpoint, I tried the create endpoint, I tried the references endpoint. None of them made sense. It didn't work out. It just wasn't going to be able to take a reference image, or it wasn't going to be able to take the prompt right or something. So we ended up settling on edits. You got to make sure you have your OpenAI API credentials. If you don't have that yet, I'll put a link in the description below for you. You can set that up. And then we're going to send a body. So you need to make sure you include all this information here. We're going to send as a body content type form data parameter. Our first parameter is n8n binary file. Name is image. That's what we're looking for. That's what OpenAI is looking for. They're looking for the image. And so we're calling it image. And it's coming from the data over here, which is the downloaded file. So that's our reference image. We're also going to do another parameter type of form data. We're going to call it model. And the model that we're using is gpt-image-1. We're going to give it something else, another form data. Name is size. And then we have the value. And for this one, I tried square. When I did square, it like cut off the top of my head. And it didn't give it all. So I made it, was this portrait style? So 1024 by x1536. I had to type that all in there. And then we have another parameter with form data. The name is prompt. And here is the prompt that we do in order to get it to make those photos. Now, I'll admit, while it does not necessarily look like me, that's a good looking photo. Like just flat out, that's a good looking picture. You get there's stubble, there's a cleft in the chin, there's creases in the tie, like creases in the, where the smile lines are. Like it looks really good. And it's got the kind of the professional background, the lighting, and hairs are kind of not 100% in place, a little out of place. Like it's absolutely a beautiful photo, I grant you. And so that's this prompt here. In order to change it for yourself, all right, what I would focus is on is, so here this first sentence says a hyper-realistic, high-resolution professional headshot of a, and I have man with a clean-shaven face and dark brown hair styled with a slight wave in front, all right? You want to change that. That's the first thing you're going to change, all right? It says the portrait is captured by a particular kind of camera, but then we're going to come down here to he has light blue-colored eyes engaged in looking at the camera with a genuine open smile that shows his teeth and gives a friendly look to his eyes. His skin is natural, even and softly textured. He is wearing a classical tailored navy blue suit jacket over a crisp white dress shirt complemented by a neatly knotted solid red tie. Change that for yourself, okay? So if you're a gentleman, if you're a man, then I would say that you can change the description of the person. So if your colors aren't light blue, or if you don't want to show your teeth, it says his skin tone is natural, even and softly textured. I'd probably keep that, maybe change it to her if you're a woman. But if you're a lady, you want to change the description of the clothing to whatever it is you would want to wear in your photo. But again, up here, the man with clean shaven face and dark brown hair, that's the only other place. Everything else in the prompt you can leave as is. It's really just kind of what is the scenario looking like, how's close the photo, that sort of thing. But it's a really solid prompt that makes really good images. And so then after that, I have a split out node. And the reason I have a split out node is because one time when I ran this, it generated multiple pictures. Now, it wasn't supposed to generate multiple pictures, but it did. And so I'm like, okay, well, if it's going to sometimes do that, I might as well include a split out node. That way it runs through the process of downloading each image that it generates. So just in case it makes more, or if you're able to change a parameter in here by adding another field to make more pictures, you want the split out node to be able to make more pictures. All right, we then pass that over to the split out node is based on data. Okay, we're splitting out on data, which is the information that's coming back from the HTTP request node. We then take that and we're going to use this convert to file node, which is set to move base64 string to file. Our base64 string input is going to be this b64_json, which came out of the split out, and we're going to output it as data. All right. And then we're going to take that. We're going to upload it to Google Drive. So again, set up your Google Drive credentials, operations upload, input is data, which is what the file is called over here. We're going to name it. I just named it with a date stamp. So date and time, so year, 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 month, month, day, day, hour, hour, minute, minute. Headshot, just went with that. And then I put it into a Google Drive folder just called Created Headshots. So you can put it wherever you want, but I just made a folder called Created Headshots. And it outputs it, and that's it. You get your photos. It took a minute. I'd say about a minute for each time I had to run it. The price is not too bad. I don't think it's set, it may already be set to high quality, but a high quality image costs about 12 cents. If you have to run this 10 times in order to get something that like looks really good, you're gonna be spending about $1.20. But that's as opposed to having to get all cleaned up and go out to a photographer and have a nice suit or a dress or whatever, a blouse. And you go out and like you don't have to spend all that time or the money of prepping for the photo if you can get one that looks nice for you here. So hopefully this is something helpful for you. I thought it was pretty cool. I might run it a few more times, see if I can't get something that looks nice for myself, then I can upload it to places. But just a nice little experiment from my community. Speaking of which, if you want to download today's workflow, all you got to do is click the link below to go to my free school community, join up there where you'll be able to get this workflow absolutely for free, as well as a ton of other workflows, a ton of other tutorials, a lot of great community, and we really hope to see you there. On top of that, you can also join my advanced community where we have even more workflows and advanced versions of the versions that I have in the free community. You get access to me 5 times a week where I'm able to answer your tech support questions, work through your workflows with you, talk about business, whatever you want, as well as additional courses. And we have our executive assistant, Roger 3.0. We got so much fun, incredible stuff happening over in the advanced community. I really hope you can join us there because that is where it is popping off, man. And as always, I'm Bradford Carlton. Let's automate your success together. I just said popping off, man.